Yo, VIP, let's kick it.
Here somewhere in London, I say somewhere because I forgot the name of the hotel, for the screening of Josh Warrington's documentary, amazing documentary. And as you can see, everyone's turned up to watch this one. I'm joking, it's finished. We've got Dev. Anyone who watches the vlog and you're not sure who you're listening to, this is him, this is what he looks like. And you'll see him in all sorts of other things as well, leading up to fights and after fights and during fights.
But never fighting, and that's key. And that's
smart
key.
Man. What happened to the podcast?
Well, it actually might be coming back, so that's a vlog exclusive.
That's a TBS vlog exclusive. You heard it from the horse's mouth here first. But yeah, it was a great documentary. Everyone's shot off. As you can see, they've just drank a lot of alcohol, empty bottles of beer, and they're gone. They've got Evian water though, so that's good pH level. Gonna get a bit of that and then shoot off, go grab a munch.
He's gonna have dinner with Zach.
Yeah.
Junior
and senior.
Junior and senior taking him out. That's the way it works. That was brutal. What's up, peeps? I'm doing something different this week. I'm about to show you my bedroom. You wanna see how the top boxer lives? This is my room, y'all. No, I'm kidding, man. I'm staying in an Airbnb because, as a lot of you may or may not know, I am no longer working with my coach, Brian Shaughnessy. We amicably parted ways, and so now I am out looking for a new coach. And as part of that, it means that I'm going around to different gyms, I'm speaking to different coaches, I'm trying out sessions, and one of the gyms that I've come to train at is so far from my house I couldn't be bothered to drive a good hour and a half to 2 hours each way per day. I decided it was best to just get Airbnb, so here I am. For those who are on my socials and haven't been seeing a lot of content of me training, the reason is I don't think it's right to, well, for starters, keep your next move quiet, right? Bear with me, guys, the top box is still live and kicking, just working in silence, you know how they do. Hopefully, very soon I'll be able to announce a new coach. Things are looking good, some good prospects, and I'm still just doing my due diligence. I'm still fit, always in shape, always eating well. And I just felt like, you know, I needed to show a bit of this. I'm showing you my journey, my life experience, insights that you don't really get from boxers, such as I only have a t-shirt and a shirt on my coat hanger. I got my oranges, I got bananas and stuff in there. But here's my cutlery set. I've got a knife, a fork, spoon. Why am I even showing you through my trash? Change shit. Boy, oh boy. Where has the summer gone, man? It's only like 5:30. And look how dark it is. So dark that I've come to a bus stop. To sit down. To record this video. I've come to this bus stop that's got better lighting. I just want to elaborate on some of the stuff that I was mentioning earlier. So, you know, like, left my coach. We couldn't agree on how to move forward with things. I just thought, here is an opportunity to brief you guys on some of the things that go on in regards to how you select a coach. If you're thinking of becoming a professional boxer, obviously one of the most important things is to surround yourself with a good team. And that starts with a good coach. A good coach could be a misleading saying, because there aren't really good coaches and bad coaches. Well, actually, yeah, there's some terrible coaches. But generally, it's about what makes sense for you, what fits you best. So when you're looking at a good coach, you're thinking, whose style of coaching complements your style of boxing? How you click with the coach? Do you get along? Do you feel like they care for you? Do you feel like they believe in you? Again, the nature of the training, does it resonate with you? Do you believe in their methods or not? Do you feel like you can trust them in the corner? And experience is something that can come into it, because an experienced coach gives you a lot less to think about or worry about. They are able to see things and foresee things that you may not, because of lack of experience, but also things that you shouldn't have to be thinking about. But then with a coach who's just like a new coach, you know, trying to make their way, or, you know, like an amateur coach turning pro, a lot of the benefits would be like they'll be enthusiastic, they'll be open to learning, they'll be committing themselves, because it's just as exciting for them as it is for you. Yeah, really, it comes down to personal preference and clicking. You've had like coaches like Joe Calzaghe's dad, peace be upon him. He never had a boxing background, especially from a coaching perspective, but he still managed to have Joe Calzaghe be a world champion for so long and retire undefeated. So clearly, experience is not a standard prerequisite, but something to look at. for a lot of people. But yeah, generally speaking for me, my own experience has been good so far. It's been very challenging, but my positive mind, I call it good because there's so many benefits to pick out from it and blessings. What I find is, so far every time I've called up a coach and phoned them up, interesting fact actually, I learned this the other day. Apparently, if you do something like chew gum when you're doing something, it distracts from what you're doing. I should stop chewing this gum. I don't want to spit it out, yo. I'm just gonna... Now look, I've got a big lip. Yeah, I'll put it inside. Kinda hidden. Put it on the other side. What about the lighting? Yeah, you can't tell I've got gum in my mouth. Yeah, so my experience has been that, you know, when I'm phoning coaches up, they're generally quite pleased and happy to hear from me or open to allowing me, welcoming me into the gyms to work with, to see how things work out. The loss hasn't seemed to be an issue to anybody so far, actually, which is quite good. I think for most people, it's quite clear that there were issues I went into that ring with. There are easy adjustments I can make from that. So yeah, I've been working with different coaches, working on different systems, different training methods, talking to coaches about, you know, their methods, and that's actually been one of the long things. Like, it's really nice because I'm getting to know these people a lot better, but it's also quite long because I'm having to analyze, not analyze to critique, but more analyze to visualize myself going through the processes that they have in place and working out if I feel like that's a system and a method that would work for me, that would suit me. But then going in and, you know, having to analyze everything that's going on in the gym. So it's the environment, it's the other fighters that they have in the gym, the way they engage with the fighters, their philosophies on boxing, how much belief they seem to have in me, and do we communicate well? Do I feel like I can take the instructions well? So many things. In regards to knowing who to reach out to, obviously I'm going off of my own thinking, but I've also spoken with friends, Frank Warren, people at Frank Warren Promotions, confidants within boxing that I speak to, and I've spoken to them and heard their opinions. The truth is, I'm so committed to boxing that I'm happy to move out of London. I'm happy to relocate for the sake of this, and I would actually move to America to box, but Frank Warren's not promoting shows there for the minute. For now, I'm looking at the UK and I'm happy to relocate wherever I have to better my career. And you know, there are other aspects as well, like sometimes you might have really high expectations of a coach. You work with them and you might find out things that meant that you can't work with them. And even though you really like them, you just can't. Sometimes it could be politics, sometimes it could be something that they do, it could be a way of that they are. In an ideal world, you'd just be able to mold people, you know, but you can't really. There's one coach in particular, actually, I was quite keen on working with. And I did, and he taught me so much in such a short space of time. Can't speak highly enough of him. Obviously, I'm not name dropping, but like, he's a phenomenal coach. And we ended up not being able to work together because of things unrelated to the actual boxing itself, particularly. I remember feeling a bit, slightly deflated about it, actually, because I was just like, this is a perfect relationship in terms of dominating the super middleweight division and just like becoming a, I mean, I'm going to be a world champion regardless, but with this guy, I believe it's going to be an exceptional world champion. And I still would be, because, you know, he's not the only excellent coach or fantastic coach that we have in the UK. But it was just one of those things where it was so close, but not quite. And it is what it is. It's good that I got to learn the things that I did. Yeah, I didn't even need to mention that. I just got to mention it for the sake of full transparency. All round, it's all good. It's all a learning experience. I'm growing from it. I'm developing from it. And I'm definitely learning a lot of things that I wouldn't learn otherwise, because now I'm learning how different people work within boxing. And that's dope, man. That's dope.